happening. No gunshots, but they getting.
Hey, what's up, you guys? Craft Farms here, back with another video. Today, I am currently on my new Eastern Dakota Farms map project. Just doing some messing around here in game, doing some testing. Right now, I'm planting this field in corn, and then gonna do a harvest and whatnot. So, yeah, this week's videos are pretty much all gonna be on this map. It's gonna kind of be the easiest thing to record right now, so yeah, so you guys will, I'll give you guys a more update when I have a video on have an in-game video on this, or a Giants Editor video on this. We're sitting here with the Challenger MT-865E. This is a tractor that was down converted from FS-17. This is one of the standard in-game tractors. And then we're pulling the DB-90 here. And then we got the T-800 hooked up to the Meridian. Seed Express 1260 to run seeds to this tractor whenever it needs it. Now, I'm just planting this one field here, so there will be like two videos of planting and then one of harvest. I don't know what I'm going to do with like the grain when harvest comes. Maybe I'll buy some bins and get them brought by the field or something. I don't know. I'll figure something out. Maybe I'll have added the sell point by then, I don't know. But yeah, so we're just gonna sit and plant here. Mirrors are a little off there. See, these are extremely long passes, that's for sure. We're only running 9 miles an hour, so. So, there's gonna be four videos. So basically, when there would be an FS-15 video and an FS-13 video, there's going to be in-game video on this. So Monday, Tuesday, are this, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday are going to be videos of doing some work on the map in Giants Editor, and then Saturday and Sunday are going to be back on this in-game here. And then over the course of this week, I'll work on getting the off-camera work done on Clover Creek and MAF MV2, so that way we can get that stuff going again, get back into it. The Thursday modding thing, that's gonna kind of go on hold. Oh, wait, no. Let me rethink that. I have my summer car videos ready to go for this week, so, yeah. Basically, when there would be an FS-15, an FS-13 video, there would be a video of this. Thursday, there will be a video on the map in Giants Editor, and then Monday, Tuesday, Friday, Saturday are videos of this. Wednesday and Sunday are my summer car, and Thursday will be in-game or Giants Editor work. Jeez. tab out here so I can close this, so that way it quits for a while. So yeah, the tractor and the truck and the map are all private. The planter is someplace, and the Seed Express is someplace. I have no idea where they're all at. You can find them somehow, somewhere. I do want to edit this planter and put a tool camera on it, so that way, so that like there's a camera right here on the planter, and then you can, you know, you can go here, and then you'd be on the planter. I like tool cameras. Since I've figured out how to add it, I've liked adding it to a lot of stuff. Just kind of a neat feature. Level this planter out here. So yeah, so far the only textures that have changed are the field, the gravel, the grass, and the dirt textures. Both the grass foliage and the texture. You know, when I say texture, I mean like the ground texture, and then foliage meaning the actual grass itself. I haven't changed any crop textures. I'm not going to do those till later on, when I'm more ready to play. I do have a fence post down there that I accidentally turned the visibility off instead of the rigid body, but I have fixed that, but I didn't save and put it in game yet. I'm not too worried about it. So we're planting, we're planting this field here. This is the only one I'm gonna plant. I could have done this one, I guess, too, but, or just that bottom one, but whatever. This one works. Kind of gets a, kind of get a feel too for how it's going to be planting on here. I mean, this is definitely not a field that I'd want to be planting with starting equipment, with something like this, what the heck is this, 5400 drill, or you know, the 6200, or like the 1760 or anything like that. This field would take forever. When we get to the end of the pass here, we're gonna move that truck over there to the edge, so it's kind of out of the way and not just sitting in the field. I don't have damage mod in or anything right now, just, you know, don't want to have to worry about it. I am gonna put damage mod into the map, like script it in, and then I'm gonna set up a place in town, or like a, not in town, but a shop to have a repair trigger in it, you know, like have a repair shop. There, if I can set it up to have two triggers for the repairs, I'm going to put one trigger at the dealership for, like, you know, to take farm equipment to, and then for like pickups and stuff, I'll have like a auto body shop or whatever, someplace in the map. Might make up a like a replica of the Firestone here in town. Although they're really not that much of a repair shop. That's just kind of more of a mechanical. But I guess, you know, it could work. need to do a second headlamp down here too. Excuse me. So if you notice, I got rid of the date and time mod. It was just kind of getting annoying with the screenshots, because it was always there and it's right where I put the watermark and everything. So just figured, you know what, I'll get rid of it. So the only thing that I really wanted it for was the time, but I have a clock sitting here next to my computer, so just look at that, I guess. So yeah, it's Saturday right now. Took my ACT test today, as I had mentioned in a video on Friday. That's when I did that. As of right now, I have no idea what I did, how I did on it. Haven't scored it yet, so I don't know when I'll find out the results. So then after I'm done recording this, somebody had asked me to do a video of my pickup, so I'll do a small update on that, because I was going to go outside and mess around for a while anyways. So reply to this message here. Actually, I know what I can do. So there will be two videos of this. One of this planting and then one of harvest. And then I'll do two videos on my map. And then the Thursday modding, I have a little project that I'm working on that I'm just starting that I'll show then. So yeah, I had to get up pretty early this morning, so that's why I keep yawning. I guess this planter has direct fertilizing too, so without soil mod, that's kind of nice, but with soil mod, that's kind of a pain. I don't know if it just puts down water or what. I'd have to look. So I'm just going to save that as one, so that way I can go back to this line when I get to the end over here, and when I get back to here, let's make it so there's three headlands on this end. I do want to put in some sugar beet stuff, because kind of in the area where this map is based, there's a lot of sugar beet and sugar beet operations. I did see a map that had sugar beets set up pretty in a pretty cool way, so I want to try, and I have to do some playing around on that map and see if I can figure out how it works, how it's set up, if it's set up as a sell point or if it's set up as storage or what. Because either way, it's still pretty cool. But as a sell point, it would still be pretty cool. And if it's if it is just a sell point, then I'll put it in as a sell point. But if it's a storage spot, I'm gonna still take it and export it and then set it up so it is a sell point, because it's a piler basically. But I don't know how the creator of that map has it set up. So you see there's a row of trees down there. You guys will see that in tomorrow's video. So I'll just show you guys some screenshots here that I took the other night on this. open this up with photos. So here's one that I took when I started planting. I was messing around with my with Reddit a little bit, messing around with the settings some more, and I really, really like the way that these three turned out. And as you can see, this date and time is just in the way, so got rid of it. Shot of the flex on the planter, flexing on a little bit of a hill, and then filling the planter. Really, really like the way that these turned out. You know, this is editing before, so, you know, big difference. Looks way nicer in my opinion. I did do a video a while back on, you know, showing what I do with editing and editing pictures and videos and whatnot. If anybody's interested, I'd be happy to do an updated video because I don't quite do it the same way that I used to. Videos are more or less the same, but pictures are totally different. And then I can also show, you know, like the programs that I use for flying and zooming and running and whatnot, all that good stuff. So if you guys are interested in that, I will put a icon up in the top right corner about here, and you can click yes or no if you would like to see an updated how I edit, or, you know, how I do screenshots and videos or whatever, something like that, something along those lines. So yeah, whatever planting is left after I record the video, I'll finish off camera before I record the next video, and then I'll get all the equipment set up and ready to rock and roll as well. I haven't decided if I want to run grain cart or if I want to run combine or truck or what yet. I think maybe what I might do is just go into GE, throw in a quick, like just a cell trigger even. You know, it doesn't even have to be someplace. Just put in a trigger or something or whatnot, and just for video, you know, for testing purposes. Like right now, there's no sell points here, are there? No. It says stuff here, but there aren't any. And then it shows points in here for different things too, but those are just shown there and those will be removed eventually. I just gotta remember how to remove them, or what I had to do to remove them. Because I removed them on my other map, but the only one I didn't get was the white ones, and I think those are storage triggers, and I don't really think that you can get rid of those ones, but I could be wrong, but I have no idea. This tractor does have some mouse controls. You can widen the tracks out or bring them in. The guy that did this, owner of Canadian Farming and Modding, the guy that also did the truck along with most of the other trucks that I use, also the creator of the the guy who released the 9620RX, he also did the MT765E, and then he's working on the other big articulated one. He's just trying to set it up with viable duals, but hasn't figured it out, and then he's also just been working on some other projects, and one of them is what I will be also working on. in Thursday's mod video, so you guys will get kind of a sneak peek at that. Guess I did hit it right away. Best thing about building a map yourself is you can build it to your computer's abilities. And like recording now, I'm still running about 60. Of course, there isn't a whole lot on the map, but still, you know, like I'm running 50-60 right now, and when I'm not recording, I can run upwards of 200 frames a second. And you know, I mean, as I add more stuff onto the map, that'll go down of course, but it'll hopefully it won't go down all that much, and you know, it'll still run very, very well. Had like 8 notifications from somebody commenting on a picture in on the Canadian Farming and Mining Facebook page. I was trying to figure out what this person was talking about. Evidently he's talking about chrome on the T8 here. Same truck that we're using, that I'm using here. One of the page members posted a picture of that truck and also the Cat CT660 that you know, they're using them for his silage crew, and somebody's commenting on how the chrome doesn't look right on the truck, but looks just fine to me. Also wasn't like a direct angle at the truck, but who knows. What are we at for time? 23. You know what? I think I will just stick to half hour because this is getting boring even for me. These are long passes and it is very boring. So I think what I'm going to do, I'm going to set up auto, well, finish recording the video and only make it a half hour instead of 45 minutes, and then I will just say, auto combine, your turn, and just let auto combine go, because active side right, collision check. Seed usage, we'll just turn that on, I guess. Lower all implements. No, there's one. Oh, show trace. So I guess we can let let auto tractor run right now. We can run around and take some screenshots and whatnot. And I guess we can also kind of run around and just kind of take a look at what's going on here. And actually, you know what else we can do? If we can, oops, sorry about that. We can buy the equipment for harvest. We can get all that purchased and ready to rock. So if I use this, I have to combine. I don't know if I want to combine or not. Because I have some nice grain carts that I kind of want to use. I got a Brent 1396, Kilbrow's 1950 green, Kilbrow's 1950 red, and then also this Unverfurth 9200. So I don't know if I want to run grain cart or if I want course play to run grain cart. Yeah, oops, I want harvesters. Yeah, I'll run grain cart. Now I just gotta decide which grain cart I want. Okay, so we'll get a 9670. We'll get a John Deere 612C. And what truck do I want to use? And we can just use the truck we got. And we can get... we'll just get a Dakota 48-foot trailer for that. And we'll just buy a second truck, I guess. And then we can just start moving stuff right now. Okay, do I want to run grain cart? Or I'm running grain cart. Which grain cart do I want? I think I'll go with this one. And then we'll get a John Deere 9420 for that. That's a pretty fitting tractor for it. So then, we actually need three pieces of stuff more. We need a CT660. We need... the Lowboy neck and the Lowboy base. There we go. So that can go there. That can go there. That can go there. And this can go here. And now we'll just back up, get hooked onto the neck and the trailer. So, I've figured out that this thing has a wooden block in it that I guess is supposed to, I forgot all about it when it was released, they said something about it that if you had this, it would sit straight. Like your truck has to have a collision set up in it and on the back, and then this block is supposed to hit that collision and then your neck will stay straight or whatever. But no truck I have evidently is set up that way, because I've never had luck with getting this stupid neck to stay. I really wish it would, but it won't. Okay, you can stop spazzing now. So all I gotta do is get it close, and then manual attaching can do the rest for me. Oh, got it. So then, we'll just pull this up here, closer to the combine. We'll get straightened out. Drop that. Go forward. Of course, the neck's gonna swing, but whatever. back up and hook on. And we can haul this combine. Combine's the only thing I'll haul. The rest of it can all just be driven. I kind of want to throw this combine in Blender and redo it. Give it kind of a more accurate paint job. I mean, this isn't terrible, but it's not the greatest either. Could use a better job, and like this ladder could be better, and it could be like a little bit newer looking, nicer looking, you know. That's just me though. Okay, this is gonna hurt. Oh, not as bad as I thought it was gonna be. Ah, what the heck, we're stuck. Lock the load. We gotta unhook that momentarily so we can drop the triaxle. We'll turn on the beacons on the trailer here and let's roll. He's still planting away. He's all right for seed, so we are all set to work with this equipment. So I still have to throw in the dealership. I'm thinking about adding it like down in this area. That's where I'll probably add like the dealership, a crop production services, and a few other things. So let's hop out here and grab another screenshot. Even if I'm not going to post the screenshots, I still like to take them. Because it's fun to mess around with them in Reddit. Play with the settings some. Okay, we're going to turn Jake Brake on. So it's ready to rock when we get there. Combine's still there, so we're doing good. Start slowing down. Take this corner nice and wide. So it'll be a little bit longer than 30 minutes, I guess, but at first I wasn't going to do this, so, whoa, see right inside the combine. Not a whole lot in that thing, that's for sure. So we'll just pull this off to the side. We'll wait to take it inside the field until harvest. Ooh, I'm getting off the road here. Yep, he's still planting away. He's still running 9 miles an hour. Oh, he's only running 7 now. Gonna be there even longer. At The good thing about running it on auto tractor, actually, we need to stop him for a moment here. Because I want to go do a headland before, because what I can do is when I go outside, I can just leave this guy run. Now, before I go out, I'll top him off with seed. You know, he might even be out by then, who knows. But then, I guess before we hire him again, we'll top him off with seed. And then he can sit and plant while I go outside. Perfect. That's how you multitask there. I guess we'll start him on this side of the field now too, because wait, no. That needs to be on that side. Cause then he can just go down here. I don't have to drive him all the way down and then drive him back and whatnot. So he can do it himself. Of course, I'm overlapping a lot, but who cares? We got flow control on the planter, or section control. Okay, so now we can get him going again. Oops, I have him on the wrong side, I bet. Let's see, I can just switch it like this, right? There we go. Now he's gonna plant. Still wonky. I guess we'll just go like this or something. Not sure how this is gonna work here now. Drop it down and hire him and see where he goes. Go, buddy. There he goes. I think. What on earth? That's not what I wanted. I don't want to go that way either. I'll take care of it myself later, I guess. Just this headland stuff. We got some equipment to finish hauling. Wait, what? Where'd my oversized stuff go now? Oh, so now it decides to work. Okay, so I think we'll just pull this off over to right here and call her good. We'll shut that off. We'll go with this guy next. Oops. Actually, a pretty nice setup here. Turn lights on. Whoa! Missed that! I knew it was coming up. I should have known that it was going to be that fast. We can roll, though. So I guess it will be more 45 minutes. As you can see, I started fencing that field. Haven't gotten very far, but I started. It'd be cool if these tarps were actually animated, like where they actually, you know, you hit the button to roll or unroll and it actually like rolled across. That'd be pretty cool. Alright, let's get this big guy going. Might be a little bit overkill for this cart, but I like the look of this on the cart. I mean, whoa, this thing is two different kinds of green. Oh, okay. But I mean, it looks good on this grain cart. Number for 9200. I like it, so. It doesn't say how much horsepower is required on this cart either, so. Can't really tell if this is a oversized tractor or not. But my dictionary, there is no such thing as overkill. There's maybe underkill, but no overkill. Underkill is definitely a possibility. Whoa! Guess the cart wants to slide. Yeah, so off camera I'll finish this planting and then Friday is when we'll do the harvesting. Got a bit of a brain fart there. Evidently, this tractor works with the Degelman blade. Never tried it. So I guess I don't know if it's working, if it's all set up for it or not. Yeah, this tractor could use a rebake too. Get the thing the same color all the way around. least this crane cart attaches pretty well. You can see it's right where it needs to be. So that's cool. I've actually never used this crane cart before. I've looked at it in Giant's Editor and bought it in game, but I've never actually put grain in it. Probably should try that. Make sure it actually works. I'm sure it does, though. I wouldn't doubt it. I guess just to see how it works. But yeah, guys, that is going to do it for this video. If you enjoyed the video, be sure to hit that thumbs up button. If you're new to the channel, welcome to the channel. Be sure to subscribe if you like what you see. Be sure to turn on the post notifications to be notified every time I upload a new video. Be sure to check out down below in the description for links to my social medias, my mod site, and other cool YouTube channels that are worth taking a look at. Thanks for watching, guys, and as always, we'll see you tomorrow.